gotta stop sucking and begin to bite it. And we'll
rise up. This is the year of women's liberation.
Through this movie and through life, we've seen a lot of Gloria Steinem, but I'm wondering sort of what is something that you might know about her that we might not expect?
Well, I don't know that it's something that I know personally, but I think that if you spend some time really listening to Gloria, you realize that she's got a great sense of humor and that she prizes it too. You know, I think when she was asked what sets her apart as an activist, she actually, or just as a person who's, you know, in this movement, she mentioned her sense of humor as contributing to her longevity. And I think that very human quality of hers, that ability to, I think, diffuse tension and to bring people together, it's a remarkable quality. It really is. It draws people in. She's a builder of alliances and of consensus. And I think her humor goes a long way toward that.
Lorraine, for a lot of people, this movie might be their introduction to Flo Kennedy. How much did you know about her coming in, and like, what did you learn about her that you just loved?
I'm somewhat embarrassed to say that I came into the film not knowing anything about her until Julie Taymor called and said, "I want you to play Flo Kennedy." And I went, "Oh, great. Yes, who's Flo Kennedy?" And then I began researching, and what a wonderful surprise. I mean, her level of activism from childhood, she was such a brave woman in the time when the ceiling was considerably lower than it is for Black women and women as it is right now. I mean, she sued Columbia because they wouldn't let her into their law school. She blackmailed them and sued them and got her way in. I mean, she was an activist, she was an attorney, she was an actor, she was a talk show host, but always, everything she did, she used that medium, that vehicle for activism, for the what she considered to be part of the second wave of feminism. So, gosh, she's become one of my true heroes.
Gloria was involved in this movie, or is, you know, and a couple of things have been done sort of about Gloria's life in the past couple of years. I'm wondering, would you guys want to participate in the movie of your life? Julianne, maybe you can tackle this one first.
No! I mean, first of all, it would be a really dull film. It'd be super, super dull. But I can't imagine I think I like, you know, I love being inside somebody else's story. I don't know that I would be able to like do my own. But I will say, the amazing thing about Gloria and working with her was how available she was to all of us. You know, how she would say, if I asked her to read a passage because I was trying to get the rhythm right, she'd be like, yeah, of course. Or, you know, and how easy she was with all of us, how her generosity was extraordinary. And I feel really, really lucky to have worked in such close proximity to her.
No, I never even watch myself on film. I mean, it's excruciating to even watch myself. But, you know, I must say, though, it might make a good movie. It's you know, this life has been a lot of things, but boring it isn't. And so I disagree with Julianne. I think it would not be boring. We just want no part of it.
Yeah. Okay, yeah.
This isn't the first time you've had knives thrown at you.
Why didn't I object? Get out and slam the door.
You will, lots of times. Speaking your mind will get you in deep trouble.
And we'll do it a thousand times again.